Rumpelstiltskin. Once upon a time, there lived a miller who had a beautiful daughter. One day, the miller happened to meet the king face to face. The king stopped and spoke to the miller. The miller boldly told him that he had a daughter who could spin straw into gold.
"Oh," said the king, "that is indeed a wonderful gift. Tomorrow, you must bring your daughter to my castle."
Then the miller was sorry he had lied, but he had to do as the king ordered. This particular king loved gold more than anything else. He led the poor girl into one of the giant castle rooms. The king said,
"There is your spinning wheel, and here is the straw. If you do not spin all of it into gold by morning, your head shall be cut off."
Then the king left the room and locked the door. Tears flowed down the poor girl's face, for she had no idea how to spin straw into gold. While she was crying, the door flew open, and a little old man stepped into the room. He had bow legs and a long red nose and wore a tall peaked cap.
"Good evening, my dear young lady. Why are you crying?"
"Oh," said the girl, "the king has ordered me to spin all this straw into gold, and I don't know how." Then the little man said,
"What will you give me if I will spin it for you?"
"This string of gold beads from my neck," said the girl. The little man took the beads and began to spin. The young girl could scarcely believe her eyes. The coarse straw was turning into glittering gold threads. The little man kept working until the entire pile of straw was transformed into gold. The next morning, the king was delighted to see the pile of gold. He led the girl to a still larger room. He said,
"There is your spinning wheel, and here is the straw. If you do not spin all of it into gold by morning, your head shall be cut off."
The maiden again began to cry. All at once, in jumped the little old bow-legged man. He took off his pointed cap and said,
"What will you give me if I help you again?"
"This ruby ring from my finger," said the maiden. The little man took the ring and began to spin. In the morning, the straw had been turned into the finest gold. When the king opened the door, how his eyes glistened! Yet as before, it made him desire even more. Taking the poor girl by the hand, he led her to an incredibly large room. This room was so full of straw that there was hardly space for her to sit at the spinning wheel. The king said,
"There is your spinning wheel, and here is the straw. If you do not spin all of it into gold by morning, your head shall be cut off. But if you do spin the gold, I will marry you."
The door closed, and the little old man came hopping and skipping into the room.
"What will you give me if I will again spin this straw for you?"
"I have nothing more to give."
"Then you must make me a promise," said the little man. "You must promise to give me your first child."
The girl made the promise. Then the little man sat down and spun all the straw into gold. When the king opened the door the next morning, the king kept his promise and married the girl. About a year later, the queen had a lovely child, but she had forgotten all about her promise. One day, the little old man came hopping into the queen's room and said,
"Now, give me what you have promised." "I will give you 3 days," he said, "and if in that time you can guess my name, you shall keep the child."
The queen lay awake that night, thinking of all the names she had ever heard of. In the morning, men were sent to every part of the kingdom to find strange names. The next day, the little man came again. The queen began to call off to him all the unusual names she had found. As she read through her list, the little man shook his head and said,
"No."
Then the queen had her men go from house to house throughout the town. They took down the name of every man, woman, and child. When the little man came again, the queen had another long list of names. He answered to each one,
"No, that is not my name."
On the third day, the queen's men began to come back. One of the men said, I came upon a little house, in front of which a little man was dancing around a fire. He wore a pointed cap and had a long nose and bowed legs. As he was hopping and jumping about, first on one leg and then the other, he sang,
My name is Rumpelstiltskin.
The queen wept with joy. She knew that at last she had found the name. At sunset, the little fellow came skipping up to the queen.
Now, he said, tell me my name.
Your name is Rumpelstiltskin. The queen was right, and so she got to keep her baby.